Despite an earthquake disaster affecting 300,000 of his own people, the King of Morocco has refused help from the United States or France. Only Britain, Spain, the UAE and Qatar have been allowed to supply aid, despite a need on the ground that locals say is desperate.
Into the fourth day, there are few miracles still to be found. Hundreds of thousands of villagers have been left to their own resources. In the high mountains of the Atlas Range, Hanifa has found alive her niece, the only survivor of her immediate family.
I will now adopt her. I will be her mother because her whole family has died.
The UN estimates some 300,000 people are homeless.
We ask the king and officials to find solutions for us. We have no place to go.
But the king has refused help from the US and France. Only four countries, including Qatar and the UAE, are considered acceptable.
It felt like, you know, a freight train had sort of started to come through.
Australian Michelle Reeves runs a tourism business in Morocco.
We've had some team members who, they come from villages in the Atlas Mountain and their whole villages have been wiped out.
An Australian charity begun by Muslims in Western Sydney is now on the ground.
And we have come within one day of seeing the news and we are trying our level best to get people the first line support, the emergency aid in the food. We've seen some people that they need shelter already and many people need mattresses and to give them some hope.
But the scale is enormous, entire villages destroyed. Even what might be saved has little value in a world without electricity or solid roofs or water or food.
We just couldn't ever imagine something like this happening here, really. It's just been totally devastating. We're just in survival mode and just trying to get help out to the people who most need it, and we'll process it afterwards.
High winds today grounded the few helicopters that might have got in, while roads in many places are not an option.
This is one of the communities we're able to get to by road, but there are a lot of communities that are just completely inaccessible due to landslides.
The old face terrifying new vulnerabilities. The young, a world forever changed. Hugh Rimmington for 10 News First.